So we have the
right prabhus vancha kalparo shakripa dubhyaya sampatana
So we have the privilege of His Grace Sridhar Shyam Prabhu joining from Dallas, and he has done a variety of farm projects across the world. So I invited him so that he can teach us about what farm projects under Krishna consciousness really mean. It's already late for him. It is 9:35. So hopefully in the next 25 minutes, half an hour, he can present whatever the key points are. Okay, without much ado, Sridhar Shyam Prabhu, take over.
Prabhuji, I was thinking, you know, whether just a little bit, I mean, should we consider exactly the topic that you have asked, or should we look at a little bit of adjustment on that? Because the problems with farm projects, etc., etc., the only thing I can share basically is, you know, the experiences in India, these 3 or 4 farm projects that I have been involved in, you know, nothing in the US basically. So I'm not exactly sure how much of that Indian challenges and concerns and scenarios will translate to American thing, basically.
It may not translate, but you could still go ahead and talk about them. Yeah, why we need farm projects, what is the current situation, what is the motivation, those kind of things.
Correct. So that exactly that is what I was hoping more to talk about. You know, the problems with farm projects or challenges will come later on. First is, you know, first we need to get devotees convinced that yes, there is a need for these, and that need is, necessity is here right now. It is actually, we are already late. That is the thing,
okay,
basically.
Yes, yeah, go with that topic, Prabhuji.
So, you know, let me offer obeisances to Srila Prabhupada, first Guru Maharaj Srila Prabhupada. Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Krishnaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vikas Swami Niti Namine. नमः ओम विष्णु पादाय कृष्ण पृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी इति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वत देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देश तारिणे जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौरभक्त वृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे All right, Hare Krishna. So, Prabhus, whoever, I think your 2 devotees whom I do not know personally. But just to, you know, I think Radhika Gopinath Prabhu has done so much more, you know, groundwork in terms of trying to put together material. You know, I have seen the presentation that he had put together, he shared with me a couple of months ago. So, a lot of groundwork he has done. But you know, my conviction about the importance of farm projects, it goes back many years ago, actually, even before getting connected to Krishna consciousness. I somehow, back in 2005-2006, I got somehow interested in food and health and nutrition, actually. Medical industry, the medical business, by the way. So, medical industry and medical business is a right term to use, because they are not, their intention is not to benefit the people. Their intention is to, it's just a business. It is to make more and more money, basically, you know. So, when I learned about those things, then I tried to understand basically what is healthier for us, you know. At that point of time itself, I understood that any food that reaches us basically through after getting produced, I mean, if the hand of industry and business has entered any field, you know, especially the food industry, the farming industry, as soon as the hand, immediately the quality of food and the nourishment and everything is spoiled, actually. You know, they try to take control. So my interest, you know, so at that point of time itself, is back in 2006, you know, I was interested from that time itself, you know, trying to source food from, you know, farmers. I started buying fresh raw milk locally, you know, back in Omaha, driving every weekend and going and getting fresh milk for a couple of families. basically like that. So that is my, with that about 3 hours minimum, or maybe even more, 3 hours, 4 hours reading on health and nutrition, including all the medical studies, and keep on doing studies, you know, on the medical field, basically studying all those things. And lot of, you know, both sides of the coin, you know, this side and the other side, the medical have the answers. And then there are other groups basically who say that these are the cheaters actually. They have no answers, they simply have poisons, you know, they'll, wherever they go, they'll create poison basically. So after spending more than a year, you know, I became totally convinced that they actually, these are the poison carriers basically. So at that time during my different material basically like that. So that is when I understood that I was already trying to find, you know, farms to source my food and things like that basically. But after, with this background, I entered Krishna consciousness actually, you know. So after, when I came to Krishna consciousness and I started learning from Srila Prabhupada that this word. So one of the things I was very confused before coming to Srila Prabhupada's shelter is that how the heck this whole world is working where everybody is only cheating. You know, I was working for PepsiCo when I moved here, and they had those people had revenues of $15 billion. And what are they doing? They are selling sugar water, which is bad for health, you know. So selling things which are bad for people's health and making their money, you know, what could be worse than that? So looking at this way, I understood everybody is cheating, but I was completely confused that how the heck everybody is cheating, every industry is cheating only. Then I came to Prabhupada's shelter and I understood when Prabhupada said that this world is a world of combination of cheaters and cheated, actually. You know? So then I understood, wow, this is that. Now my confusion is gone, actually, you know. So this is the word, you know, this word is that kind of a place. And Srila Prabhupada, when you investigate Srila Prabhupada's teachings, you know, right from the beginning, he's advertising, he's saying that thing, pushing people, devotees on this, you know, you read the canto, the first canto purports where Prabhupada is glorifying, you know, simple living, high thinking, Krishna Balram way of life, the Vrindavan way of life, like that he's glorifying all the time. And not only is glorifying that, but he's also demonizing. He's telling that this modern civilization is not a human civilization. It is a demonic civilization, basically. Prabhupada is saying that again and again, all these things, basically. You know? So with that background, when we, as the faith, my faith in Srila Prabhupada started growing, and as I started seeing, experiencing the happiness of Krishna consciousness, and the complete, you know, disinterest of normal people, you know, my colleagues and anybody I would try to talk to about Krishna, nobody is interested, basically. So that's when I understood that, I mean, my heart was hankering, you know, right from 2008-9 onwards for devotee association. But the only devotee association I used to get was like 1 or 2 hours, 2 hours, 3 hours on Sunday evening when we go to the temple. And even then we have our services, we have to attend the temple programs, classes and kirtans. So there is no really time to talk and discuss anything about Krishna, you know. So when Krishna says in the 10th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, you know, that the devotees, they are happy and blissful discussing about me among themselves, I could see that was completely lacking and almost impossible in the modern lifestyle. And that's when I started realizing that if we really want to practice Krishna consciousness, what Prabhupada is saying, what Krishna is saying, then this is not the lifestyle for doing that. No way, basically. So we may want to keep ourselves in an illusion that, you know, that we are practicing Krishna consciousness, but it is it's a dim shadow. It's not even a shadow, it's a reflection of Krishna consciousness practice. It is not real Krishna consciousness practicing, actually. No. So that was then, and now is now. So when I started understanding the importance of farm and that kind of life, and I could see that in America there is no farms, you know, and then I got connected with His Holiness Bhaktivikas Swami Maharaj in 2011, you know, and then I started seeing that His disciples, you know, they started making attempts, serious attempts at trying to set up farm projects in India, different places actually. So over the years, there are four or five of them have come up actually, you know, and they have been different levels of success. There have been challenges and all those things are there, basically. But I have tried, you know, at my personal level best to try to support those farm projects, you know, because we don't have any takers for farm projects here, and farm projects are required. Prabhupada says it over and over again, you know. So, and I want to try, you know, my whole desire has been to actually live on a farm with devotees, and I could not do. So I thought the least I could do is support those who are trying to do that. Support those who are sincere enough to give up their material lives and put their faith in Prabhupada and Krishna's teachings and go for the simple life. So in Gujarat, like 5 or 6, 7 godbrothers of our mine, you know, they left well-paying jobs, you know, 1 lakh, 2 lakh per month earning jobs. They gave up in India and started a farm projects like that, basically. And I remember listening to lectures back in 11, it's 2011 or 12, that when Guru Maharaj visited the farm after four, five, 6 months of them started, and this was not even a farm, they were just had built some cottages, had started living together and trying to grow some vegetables, not really any farm as such, you know. Guru Maharaj made the remark there that your faces have become dark, you know, but they have become darker because of the sun, but they have become brighter because of happiness of Krishna consciousness. Anyway, so that's the background. And since then, because I could not participate in any farm project here because there is nothing there. So, you know, I have simply tried to support the farm projects in India. Saying, but then eventually when we were forced to start working from home at my place where I work, Capital One Bank, you know, that's when I started taking it seriously. Not started taking coronavirus seriously, but I started taking seriously to try to investigate what the heck is going on in this world. You know, is coronavirus real or not real, or you know, what is going on? And my research actually took me about a month or 2 months to figure these things out. And of course, by Krishna's mercy, nothing happens without his mercy. But, you know, somehow Lord Krishna guided me to different information, pieces of information, different places, websites, YouTube videos and different places. Somehow this whole piece of the puzzle came together, basically, you know. And many senior devotees also, two to three Prabhupada disciples who are senior devotees and who are astrologers actually, they also predicting that by end of this year, things are going to start turning real bad. And the Parit Pavan Prabhu in Europe, Prabhupada disciple is astrologer, Mithun Twins, his website or, you know, whatever his company is called. Couple of other devotees, you go on the YouTube, basically I'll send Radhika Gopinath Prabhu couple of other videos. I sent you one, I'll send you a couple more, Prabhuji. I told you about that secular, you know, very IT professional, semiconductor industry professional who was astrologer from childhood. His father was astrologer from India. So he learned, so he doesn't make any money with astrology. He also predicting that from November, December onwards, things are going to get really bad. And next 14, 15 years is a time of great upheaval in this whole world. This whole world is, and this is in order to bring in a new era of mode of goodness. You know, this golden period, Lord Chaitanya has said that there will be 10,000 year period. You know, so the 10,000 year period started from Lord Chaitanya's appearance itself. But this, I am very strongly convinced of the fact, after doing a lot of research, that now is the time when Srila Prabhupada said that there will come a time where there will be, you know, huge unemployment, no food to eat, no place to go. Cities will become, you know, torn by riots, you know, like that. People killing and all these kind of things going on in the cities, no food and all these things. I feel that that kind of that time that Prabhupada talked about, you know, it is not, Prabhupada is not trying to scare us, you know, actually, don't think like that. Prabhupada is a pure devotee personality of Godhead, messenger of Krishna. He has no business in scare, you know, he is simply stating the facts. So whether those dire situations, dire circumstances, they happen in, you know, end of this year, early next year, or take 1 or 2 years to happen, I am strongly convinced that it is that the wheel of time has started turning now, actually. And I personally, you know, somehow by grace of the Lord and my Guru Maharaj's blessings and Shubha's, you know, guidance, we are trying that even though I cannot go, my family is here, we cannot go to the farm, but we have to live through these times which are going to come. There are predictions in astrological predictions by some well-known, decently well-known astrologers, actually, that over the next 15 years, there will be natural disturbances all world, there will be wars of different kinds, and almost 20-25% of the world population is going to get lost, actually. You know, and there are many many times Srila Prabhupada said, you know, in late 60s, early 70s, that the civilization is not going to last long. You know, he said 50-60 years, maximum 100 years is what he said, you know. And then a couple of other instances were there where he said there was a that is part of this book, Perfect Questions. Life Comes from Life, that discussion, morning walk series, basically, where devotee talking to Prabhupada and they say, Prabhupada is saying that these people are all cheating you. And the devotee saying, yes, yes, Prabhupada, they have been cheating us for thousands of years. Prabhupada says, no, not cheating thousands of years. This started recently, said about 200 years ago. This, with the advent of this modern science, is started cheating you. Basically, Prabhupada said that very clearly. And then Prabhupada says that, and it's not going to go on very long. Maximum 50 more years, Prabhupada says, you know, and it is finished, the civilization, basically. So that discussion, morning walk, happened in 73. So if you add 50 years from that, it puts us into 2023, which is just around down the corner, basically, you know. So looking at a lot of these things, looking at the economic situation, you know, and also researching this coronavirus thing, basically, just to give you one statistic. In the first quarter of this year in US, total number of deaths from all causes is called all-cause mortality. It was down by 6% compared to the average of last 3 years, you know. So when I look at information like that, then I have very difficulty to actually believe, you know, that this coronavirus is real. You know, there is something going on. You know, I feel like that there is it's a propaganda hype. You know, they are labeling everything and anything, any kind of death, anybody happens as coronavirus basic death. You know, so God knows, Krishna knows what the heck is happening, but this world is currently being run by demons basically, and that, as Krishna says in the 16th chapter, you know, that Shayo Jagata Hitaha, that all these nonsense, you know, what to say, Ugra Karma, it is eventually going to bring the world, you know, down. It will bring, create great disturbance and upheaval in the world. So that time is already here. You can see that, you know, everything is topsy-turvy now. You know, cannot depend on any, you cannot talk any reasonable things to anybody in this country or in Europe or in the modern times. Nobody is reasonable. The difference between man and woman is gone. They cannot understand that women are different, you know, different bodies, different mentalities. They cannot understand things, simple things, you know. So this world is coming, this chapter of this world is coming to a close. I'm strongly convinced based on Prabhupada's teachings. And at least here in Dallas area, you know, with the grace of our, you know, God brothers and other few other devotees in our Bhakti Vriksha, and three of them are here already in this session also, Sage Dev Prabhu, Kishori Kishore Prabhu, Divyanam Prabhu. We are in the process of starting a farm project here, basically, you know. So we don't know how it will happen, what will happen, but our desire One thing is 100% sure that if you do things under the instructions of our senior acharyas and guru rajas, if you simply try to follow the instructions in good faith, in sincerity, you know, then nothing bad can happen actually, because you know, just like Arjuna was killing under the instruction of Krishna, but sin not touch Arjuna because he is simply following instructions. Similarly, when we follow instructions of Srila Prabhupada and do what he wants told us to do, you know, there's no such chance of failure if we do it properly, basically. So that is what we are, you know, we are in the process of doing that in Dallas here. We are in the process of acquiring a farm, you know. So this thing process takes, you know, the financing and closing the deal and all these things take time. So hopefully by end of October, sometime middle or end of October, we hope to get possession of that farm. So that is our conviction that by trying to follow this simple living and high thinking life, we can become very happy, and anybody who comes and sees us, you know, of course a lot of research, a lot of hard work is there in the beginning basically, but with this whole civilization collapsing around us, Srila Prabhupada said millions of people will come to our Hare Krishna farms and we must accept them, give them food, you know, give them a place to stay and put them to work on our farms. That's what Prabhupada told one of his disciples who was a BVT head, trustee at that, Rameshwar Prabhu. There's a 2-minute video on YouTube. You know, you can watch Adiya Gupna Prabhu can video. So these are the things that there is actually no happiness in the real world, and we are supposed to take shelter of Krishna, not shelter of money, which is Lakshmi. You know, so that is the point. We should try to take shelter of Krishna and not money, not Lakshmi ji. Lakshmi ji is also there, but eventually, if we don't have surrender and service to Krishna, then Lakshmi won't stay also. These are some of the points. They may sound a little bit harsh, but these are I'll stop my monologue here. If there are any questions or discussion points, we can do it.
Yes, so we have two new people, like, you know, Sheshdev Prabhu, Kishori Prabhu, and Divyanam Prabhu are already, you know, known to you. But maybe Disha and Jaipal, if you have any questions?
Yes, Prabhu. Hare Krishna, I do have a question about farmhouse and what is it, like, what are the teachings of how to do a farmhouse, the beginnings, something basics. Totally understand the whole situation that we are in right now. It is it's going into garbage, but if you want to start from basic, where does somebody start doing a farm project or being close to earth?
That is a very good question actually, Mataji. But those are things that we are right now in the process of trying to figure out. The reason is because farm projects in India and farm projects here, they are very different in nature actually, you know. And the farm projects in India, they were all devotee farm projects, basically where a few group of devotees, 4, 5, 6 families, they decided, and you know, they reached out to other devotees for helping them financially, and they bought a piece of land, you know, so, and built some cottages and started like that. I don't think that is practical in America. You know, some devotees might have tried those things here, but apparently we can see, because there is no running farm projects like that, so that means things been successful much from that angle. So our approach here is, you know, multi-pronged. Is that one thing is that we are trying to do this project as a group, you know, so 4, 5, 6 devotees families, actually we are all participating together, you know, buying a farm basically, which has, you know, house already on it, so living there is, you don't have to spend money in building a house. So, and I mean, most of my research, last 2-3 months, I've been researching these things also as to how to make it So the point is, we even if we buy a farm here, you know, it will be on financing basis basically. You know, we'll have to take a bank loan, etc., etc., which is actually very good because the way things are. Again, another angle which I did not mention about is another that has discovered in my research in the last 3-4 months is that 4-5 months research that this economic system is actually about to collapse. It has started collapsing. You know, but we don't see it yet. You know, the results will be soon, you know, within few months to maybe by middle or end of next year, we will see the results. But this whole economic system of this world, it is already in a very, very bad state of collapse. And there is no hope. If anybody is hoping that things will come back to normal, you know, that's a hope against hope. It's a foolhardy hope, I would say. So, be very careful. Do not trust this whole economic system. Prabhupada also said that these people are cheating you by giving you paper money. That is not money. The real money is gold and silver or land and grains and food and cows. Basically, that is real wealth. This is not real wealth at all, you know. So, as far as possible, as a group, what we do is, you know, trying to move all the cash or whatever Lakshmi that Krishna has in custody of our families, you know, 5-6 families here. We're trying to, you know, percentage, small part of that into these farm projects, basically, and into precious metals, what Srila Prabhupada and Acharya say, is the actual real money. Basically, the money is gold and silver. Paper currency is not really money because it is simply based on faith. There's no value. There have been total number of about 6,000 plus currencies in the world in the last 3,400 years. Each and every currency of the world, it has ended its lifespan by becoming zero in value, actually. So dollar and other currencies of the world are no different. They will all go to zero in value eventually. Now, whether it's going to happen right away in the next few months or 2, 3 years, 5 years, we don't know. But the time has started. The clock is clicking.
I just wanted to add something to your statement, Sridhar Shyam Prabhu. Like, since Corona started, US government has printed $3.4 trillion paper money, right? $3.4 trillion. And if you look at the last 50 years, they probably printed equivalent amount of money. So what has happened in the last 4-5 months is unusual, right? So which means the dollar is now only worth about 40 cents right now, or maybe 33 cents. It's probably fell down by a third in its value. Just wanted to add that.
I have spent hundreds of hours of, you know, I mean, if any of you, what I have found is I do so much research and I find this information and YouTube videos and ebooks and things like that. And I send to other devotees and I have found that, you know, hardly even one devotee will read those things. Okay. So, you know, that's a problem I see basically that. So if devotees are not willing to read, then they have to put trust in somebody who is reading, you know, and so otherwise you take your own decision and read this. And if not, then when things go bad, then you should not blame anybody, you know, we can only ourselves to blame. So you are right, Prabhuji, you know, that what they call as M1, M2 cash, basically these things. The total amount of currency in 2008 in America was dollar in circulation was $0.8 trillion. And because of this whole banking system crash, economy crash in 2008, 9, 10, 11, 12, by the time we came out of, you know, so-called came out of, but we never really came out of it. It just looks like that. And by 2014, the amount of currency was, you know, $4 trillion total. Okay. And now, as you said, in the 5 months, they have printed $4 trillion again. So they have doubled it actually, you know. There's a serious inflation there, but it is just waiting under the wings to happen actually, you know. So that is my request, that is my advice, you know. So now coming back to the farm thing, what our intention is, and there are videos on this, you know, there are many farms, you know, several farm people projects in the world, in Europe and America, in India, you know, that, I mean, non-devotees, they're not devotee projects, but this on like 2 acres, 3 acres, basically, people have been able to grow the I mean, they have to do it systematically, learn it basically, you know, and they do what they call as market gardens, basically, market gardens. So they will produce tables, so many different 20, 30, 40 kinds of vegetables, basically with a focus that they will sell to the public, basically, not to the, some of them they are able to sell to the restaurant. Sometimes you are able to sell to, you know, higher end food stores like Whole Foods, etc., which are proud to, you know, sell local produce and buy it at a decent rate. But the best thing what I have found is something called CSA, you know, customer service agreement or something like that. We find families basically who, and with that an agreement that every week we'll provide you, you know, 10, 15 pounds or 20 pounds of this combination of different vegetables and some fruits, and you pay us like, you know, 50 bucks or something every week like that. So 4 weeks you supply, every month you get $200. You know, you make 20 or 30 of such families as your customer, regular customers, and out of 1-2 acre farm, people to produce, you know, when done properly or with some investment and some research and some hard work, on 1-2 acres, people are able to provide 100 families. So food Mother Earth can give, actually. That's the reason, that is why the Earth is called Mother. She can give so much, basically. So the intention is to take the shelter of mother, just like, you know, when we are born, we take shelter of our mothers. You know, similarly, we should throughout our life take shelter of Mother Earth and Mother Cow. Those are the teachings, basically. So we start in that manner, you know, with market gardens, basically, and trying to solicit. You know, there are so many people, a good percentage of population in this country now is aware of the benefits of healthy, organic, and not even organic. What we should do is beyond organic, actually, you know, and they will be happy and willing to pay premium prices for that, you know. So my goal is, our goal of the project is that, you know, that every weekend, basically, we'll simply fill up our pickup truck in from the farm and come to the temple and distribute to the devotees, sell to the devotees, basically, you know. And every weekend, even if we are able to produce like 2,000 pounds of vegetables, assuming the average price of, you know, $3, $2 to $3, you know, or maybe $2, even if we bring 1,000 pounds of vegetables every week, you know, $2,000 cash we can get, basically. Of course, not all is profit, but do it 4 times a month, you get 8,000 cash, you know. So even if, and this is perfectly possible with 2 families, actually, 3 to 4 people, 4 people working, two adults, 2 males, and maybe one or two Matajis working can do that. Of course, we have to do some study, some research, reach out to people who have done it, watch a lot of YouTube videos, read some books like that, you know, or simply try to, you know, give a consulting to $2,000 to somebody and ask their help in planning and designing all these things, basically. And the farm is purchased, there may be like $40,000-$50,000 of setup cost, you know, for farm beds and, you know, all these kind of things, seeds and some equipment and small equipment and things like that. But that is where the intention is, that, you know, we will not focus on the grains in the business. We will focus more on the garden, on the vegetables produced that we can, you know, directly supply to customers, primarily devotees, you know. And if devotees are not willing to buy, we'll reach out to outside people. There is such a good, you know, pretty large customer base of people, you know, which will sell things for so expensive organic produce, you know. So many, there are so many stores all over the country selling stuff, you know. So if we sell at the same price and the quality of our produce, 5 times, 10 times what is sold in Whole Foods, you know, because organic is really just a stamp, you know, it doesn't really mean much more nutrition, actually. So that is the way we are saying that, okay, first we will try to focus on economics, that, okay, you can produce what we can sell, and then slowly as the money pressure becomes less, then we move on to other things, basically. Okay, then go grow some dal, grow some grains, get 1 or 2 cows, like that. So that is the process, is what we are planning to do.
Thank you, Prabhu.
So any questions, Jaypal?
Yeah, no, Prabhuji. Thank you.
So the Dallas Vasis, I think it is getting late for you. I thank you for coming to this class. And yeah, we'll be in this dialogue continuously. So feel free to drop off now. So I'll have my regular class for my students. You are welcome to stay. Today I'm going Today I'm going to cover soil science, actually, believe it or not, because most people don't know what soil is. So I'm teaching soil science today.
So Prabhuji, please record it. I would also want to watch it later on or hear it, because I also need to learn these things, you know.
Right.
But we have so many things to learn.
Yeah, America is a great country in terms of agricultural universities. Most of the universities started as agricultural universities. So there's a lot of research. Modern Americans don't care about it, but they historically, they have done a lot of work, good work, actually. So yeah, feel free to, stay along because
okay, Prabhuji.
It's an important topic. And if you have to drop, you have to drop.
No, Prabhuji, I drop, Prabhuji, take your blessings.
Okay. So I'm starting to share my screen.